What's up, Edge Traders? This is Adam Winnick here with a complete MetaTrader 4 tutorial for beginners. Here's everything that you need to know about using the MetaTrader 4 platform, and here's how this is going to work. We're going to break down everything that you need to know on desktop, and then at the end of the video, I'm going to hop in on mobile. I think it's good that you understand both platforms, but here's a quick look at everything that we're going to be covering. We're going to be covering how to download the MetaTrader 4 terminal, how to log into your brokerage account, how to add symbols in the MarketWatch, the Navigator, the terminal, open trades and trade history, opening a chart, changing time frames, placing a trade, market orders versus pending orders, modifying trades, customizing charts, drawing lines and objects, adding indicators, saving a chart as default, installing custom indicators, and installing EAs. All of that is coming right now. Okay, this is the only MetaTrader 4 tutorial video that you need to watch. My goal is to make this as complete as humanly possible and as simple as humanly possible so you can totally master MetaTrader 4 in just this quick short video. And if this video helps you, would you consider taking a second to just hit the like button as well as subscribe to this channel? We created this channel to help make your trading elf easy, lucrative, and fun. So let's get into it right now. So first things first is how to download the MetaTrader 4 terminal to your computer. It's really, really simple. All you need to do is type in your broker account, which I'm using LQDFX in this scenario, and then MetaTrader 4 download, and you'll simply basically just click on the platform that they give you, and then you'll just download it to your computer. Once you download it to your computer, you'll simply click run, and when you click run, something's going to pop up that's going to look just like this. Okay, so that's how to download the terminal. Next, how do you actually log into your brokerage account? Well, there's a couple ways. At the bottom right here, you can go ahead and you can click log in here, and you can put in your brokerage account number as well as your password right here. Also, you have the option right here to file log into trade account. Again, you put in your account number as well as your password right here. Now you can also open a new demo account if you'd like to. So you can just click open an account, and then you're going to have to just search for the broker server. So you just type in, for example, if you're trading with FX Choice, you type in FX Choice, and then you select which server you want to be on. For example, their demo server. You click next, and then you can open a new demo account by clicking next, or you can log into an existing account like that. So once you're logged in, it should look something like this, and you can see that it's green here at the bottom, which basically means that I'm logged in. Okay. The next thing that you're going to want to understand is the market watch. So here's how we can have a list of currencies that we'd like to trade. So if I want to get rid of it, I can just pop it off right here, and then I can click this button right here to add the market watch again. Now you can go here and you can click hide all, and it'll remove all symbols from your market watch. You can come in here and you click show all, and it'll show all of them again. Okay, so I'm going to hide all of them, and you can also just add individual ones that you'd like to add. So for example, let's say that I just want to add the major Forex pairs. I can just go in here and I can click, and I can add all of the Forex major pairs just like that, and wabam, we have them here in our market watch. Another thing that you can do in the market watch is you can see the spread. So this is sometimes helpful. So you can go ahead and see the spread right here. So that's the market watch. Next, moving on to the navigator. So this is the navigator window. You can close it out just again like here, and you could also open it up again just by clicking that button here. Basically here you can see which account that you're logged into. If you're playing on multiple different accounts, you can switch from your accounts right here. You can also see all of the different indicators, which you can drag onto the chart, which we'll explain later, as well as any expert advisors that you may be using. We'll go over how to install an expert advisor later on in this video as well. So that's the navigator. The last part is the terminal. Okay, so you can go ahead and you can exit out the terminal right here, and then you can click it back on right here to see the terminal. The terminal is basically has these tabs right here. So the trade tab is going to show you any open trades that you may have going on right here. And then the other most popular thing that you're going to look at in the terminal is your account history. So here you can see your profit loss, as well as any details of any open trades that you have made. Everything else you're not really going to use a lot unless you're using like an expert advisor. You'll need to check here occasionally, or maybe your journal. It'll basically show you everything that you've done inside of MetaTrader 4, but you won't really need to look at that a whole lot. Okay, mainly just the trade and account history tab. Next thing, how to open a chart. So how to open a chart, basically there's a couple ways. You can open a chart from here and you can click on the pair that you'd like to open. But the way that I do it is I just right click on the currency pair that I'd like to trade, and then I just click chart window. Okay, and there you can see it's opened a chart just like this. Now, as far as changing the time frame, you can see up here you can change it to the M1, M5, M15, M30, H1, H4, daily, weekly, or the monthly chart, depending on what time frame that you actually want to look at. So just playing around with this, you can maximize the chart just like this. You can zoom in like this. You'll probably want to be looking at candlesticks, so you can click candlesticks, or if you would prefer to see a line chart for some reason, you can can click line chart there, but more than likely you're going to be wanting to look at candlesticks. So you can zoom in just like this, and that's how you open a chart, just like that. The next thing that we're going to talk about is how do you actually place an order? So there's several ways that you can place an order, but the way that you more than likely will want to place an order is just by going up here. You can click down this little drop down arrow. It's probably the fastest way to do it. And then you can select your risk right here. So you can put in your lot size, so let's say 0.1, and then you can click buy or sell. So this is a market order. And the first time that you do this, you're going to have to accept these terms and conditions. And there you go. I can go ahead and I can click buy here, and boom, there I have an open trade. There's other ways that you can open a trade. You can go here and you can select, for example, just right click on the chart, and you can say you want to do like a sell limit. You could also do like a buy stop. You could also click new order here, and you could customize it. So basically you can say you want your lot size here. This is where I want my stop loss to be. This is how, where I want my take profit to be. And this is the type of order that I want to do. So you could do a market order, which is going to get into the market immediately, or you can do a pending order, which would be like a buy limit or a sell limit or a buy stop or a sell stop. And I'm not going to get into explaining those because that's not the purpose of this video. This is just a tutorial. So more often than not, you're likely going to just be taking the trade like this. And then as far as modifying the trade, here's how you can modify the trade. So down here in the trade window, you can see the trade, right? You can right click on here and you can select modify or delete order. And here you can change what you'd like to change. So you can you know, decide to put your take profit at whatever level you'd like to put your take profit at. You could also put your stop loss at whatever level you'd like to put your stop loss at, and you'll just click modify. Another way to modify trades, which is probably easier, is you can just click on that green line and then you can drag it. So here you can see the stop loss I put here, and then the take profit I just clicked and I dragged it up here. And there I put my take profit right there. So that's how you can modify orders. Okay, next thing is customizing your chart on MetaTrader 4. So you can basically right click on here and then you can go down to properties, and a list of properties will show up that looks just like this. So if you wanna change the background from black to say white, for example, you can do that like that. We'll leave it at black for now. The foreground you can also change, which you can see what happens when I change the foreground. Yeah, you can see it here. So if you change the foreground to say red, for example, that's basically the price, the X and Y axis doing that. I like to leave it just at white like that. The grid, so if you'd like to have a grid, you can do a grid, or you can actually completely remove the grid, which is kind of nice like that. So for bar up, you can have it be whatever color that you want to. And then for a bar down, you could have it be say like white, for example, right? That's a bar down. A bullish candle, you can make that, you know, say you want to make that, you know, lime green, you can do it like that. So that way it kind of looks nice like that. And anyways, you can change all of this stuff right here to make the chart exactly the way that you want the chart to look like. So there you have it. The next thing that we're going to cover is how to draw lines and objects. So you can just come up here to insert, and then you can click on lines and you can click how you'd like to draw. So you could do, for example, like a trend line. So you could, you know, draw a trend line just like that, and wha-bam, okay, you have a trend line. Or there's other things that you can draw. Obviously you can play around with this here. You can draw different shapes. If you'd like to draw like a rectangle, you could draw like a rectangle around this consolidation zone. You could do also like a horizontal line. So you could just click wherever you want the horizontal line to go, and it'll pull out the horizontal line just like that. Okay, so that's how to draw lines and objects on the chart. The next thing that I'm going to show you how to do is how to add custom indicators. So basically, I'm going to show you how to add common indicators. So you can go to insert indicators, and then you can decide whatever indicator that you'd like to use. So maybe you'd like to use a moving average. You just go under trend and you go into moving average, and then you could select the period. Let's say that I want a 20 period. Let's say that I want an exponential moving average. And let's say that I want this to show up as like this aqua color here. And then you can just go ahead and you click OK, and then boom, it'll draw it on the chart just like that. Again, and you can see all of the different indicators right here under the indicator tab, whatever one that you'd like to trade, as well as you can see indicators right down here. So you can simply just drag, for example, the RSI. If you wanted to have the RSI on there, you could just drag it on there and customize your settings, your colors, all that sort of stuff. And then boom, it would show up on the chart right here, and you can just drag that down. So that's how you add indicators to the chart. The next thing that you want to do is save the chart as default. So this is going to help you a lot. So once you've got an idea of what you want on your chart, say you want the moving average, you want the RSI, and you want it to be this look and feel, you can right click and you can click on template and you can click save template. And then if you just type in default and you click save, then anytime you open a new chart, it's automatically going to have your default settings installed. So for example, I can go ahead and chart window, and boom, it has the moving average, it has the chart the way that I like it to see, it has the RSI, as well as it has the time frame that is set as my default chart. So this is really helpful to actually save you a lot of time from having to go in and put on all that stuff every single time. time. Okay, the next thing is we're gonna show you how to install custom indicators. So custom indicators is really simple. All you're gonna do is you're gonna go to File, Open Data Folder, okay? You're gonna click on MQL4, and then you're gonna click on Indicators, and then all you're gonna do is copy and paste your indicator file inside of here, and then you can go ahead and close out, and you'll just go back over to your indicators window in the Navigator, and you'll just click Refresh, and then you'll see the indicator loaded in there. Now, if you wanna install an Expert Advisor, you wanna install a 4X robot, then you just go to Open Data Folder, MQL4, Experts, and then you would install it right here. You just copy the file and you'd paste the file right here. And then same thing, you just come over here to the Navigator, you go to Expert Advisors, and you would refresh just like so, and there you have it, right? So that's how you do everything on MetaTrader 4 on your desktop. Yeah, again, if this was helpful, then go ahead and click like and subscribe to this channel. And now I'm gonna get in and actually show you how to use the MetaTrader 4 phone app. Okay, so now I'm gonna show you how to use the MetaTrader 4 app on your phone. So you're just gonna wanna download it from the App Store, and it looks like this. So you just pull it open, and when you get it open, you're probably gonna get taken to a screen that looks like this. At this point, you can go ahead and you can click on this plus icon, and you can either decide if you'd like to open a new demo account or if you'd like to log into an existing demo account. Then you just search for your company server. So just start by searching whatever the broker's name is up here. I'm just gonna do this, and then all you're gonna do is put in your broker number and password. So I'm gonna do that really quick. Okay, so now you can see that I'm logged into my brokerage account, and down here at the bottom, you'll see quotes. So here's, I can see the different quotes for the different currency pairs. If I wanna go ahead and add another currency pair to the watch list, so to speak, then you can just go ahead and basically click on the plus button to add it, and there you have it. Then you can also go ahead and take a look at the chart just by doing this. You can change the time frame up here on the top right to whatever time frame that you'd like to see. You can also use these crosshairs here like this if you'd like to. You can also draw stuff if you'd like to. So you can just click on, you know, whatever you'd like to draw on here as well, which it looks like it drew it up there for whatever reason, but you get the idea. Then if you'd like to trade, you can go ahead and click trade, and you can click your lot size right here. So let's say that I want to do a 0.1 lot size, and then you can go ahead, click sell or click buy, just like that. You can see your open trades right here, just like that. And you can see your trade history right here, which you can search by day, week, month, or you can do a custom time frame just like that. And then as far as the settings go, you can play around with it, but the MetaTrader 4 app is kind of really, really simple. You can change the language here. You can also change kind of what the charts look like. So if you want to see a bar chart or a line chart or what you want to see on the charts, you can change that here. But again, it's really, really simple. And if you play around with it for 5 minutes, you'll understand everything that the MetaTrader 4 phone app can actually do. Okay, that was the complete MetaTrader 4 tutorial for beginners. Now, I'm guessing since you are a beginner, you probably are wanting to learn a little bit more about Forex. So I've included this video here where I break down basically an entire beginner's tutorial. Go ahead and click that video and check it out. Also, give us a like and subscribe if this video was helpful. We have a ton of more videos on this channel to help make your trading ELF easy, lucrative, and fun.